गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टडी क्लास 8, चैप्टर 8, दैट इज सेल एंड इट्स फंक्शन. इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैड स्टडीड अबाउट द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ द सेल. इन टुडेज लेक्चर आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट द पार्ट्स ऑफ द सेल. सो हेयर द पार्ट ऑफ द सेल, द नंबर वन इज सेल मेम्ब्रेन. So, a cell contains number of the basic components, that is cell membrane, cytoplasm and the nucleus. So, the basic component of the cell is cell membrane, cytoplasm and nucleus. Cytoplasm and nucleus are placed in the cell membrane and that is together called plasma membrane. So, the membrane that separates cell from one another and also the cell from surrounding. So the plasma membrane is porous and allow the movement of substances or material both inward and outward. So plasma membrane we can say is a permeable membrane which can allow the movement from in and out. So the boundary, main the boundary of the cell is the cell membrane that is covered by another thick covering that is called cell wall. As the cell body contain a dense round body in the center that is called nucleus. Here we have studied about cell membrane, plasma membrane, cell wall and the nucleus. So cell membrane is the outer covering of the cell. And the outer covering of the cell has a thick membrane that is called cell wall. Cell wall contain a central thick region that is called nucleus. And the jelly-like substance between the nucleus and the cell membrane is called cytoplasm. So here we have studied about cell wall, cell membrane, plasma membrane, nucleus and then cytoplasm. So cytoplasm is the jelly-like liquid which is placed between the nucleus and the cell membrane. So mainly cell membrane gives the shape to the cell, or the cell membrane has outer thick covering that is thick layer that is only present in plants, that is cell wall. So we can say that cell wall is present only in plant cell. So that cell membrane or cell wall provides the plant protection. So it also helps to protect against temperature variation, high wind speed, atmospheric moisture. So in this way, a cell wall is very important for the protection of the plant. So it is present in the present only plant cell. So here you can see the structure of human cheek cell. So where the jelly-like substance is called cytoplasm, and the covering of these central part is called nucleus. So the covering of that nucleus is called nuclear membrane, and that outer covering of the cell is called cell membrane. So here is the diagram, and the jelly-like substance that is cytoplasm, it is lies between the nucleus and the cell membrane. So cytoplasm, it is a jelly-like substance present between the cell membrane and the nucleus. But this cytoplasm is a fluid which contains different components or organelles of cell. So mitochondria, Golgi bodies, ribosomes, etc. So about these different type of organelles, you will study in higher classes. So nucleus, it is an important component of the living cell. It is spherical and located in the center of the cell. As you see here, nucleus is located at the center of the cell. So न्यूक्लियस इज सेपरेटेड फ्रॉम द साइटोप्लाज्म बाय द मेम्ब्रेन कॉल्ड न्यूक्लियर मेम्ब्रेन. सो आउटर कवरिंग ऑफ न्यूक्लियस इज कॉल्ड न्यूक्लियर मेम्ब्रेन. सो दैट मेम्ब्रेन इज आल्सो पोरस एज प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन. सो व्हाई इट इज पोरस और व्हाट डज पोरस मींस, इट अलाउ द मूवमेंट ऑफ मटेरियल बिटवीन साइटोप्लाज्म एंड इनसाइड द न्यूक्लियस. सो मूवमेंट ऑफ द मटेरियल्स बिकम ईजी. So the small spherical body in the nucleus is called nucleolus. So firstly we have a outer covering, it is cell wall in plants only. Then we have cell membrane. After cell membrane we have a jelly liquid, that is cytoplasm. So then after that there is a membrane, that is called nuclear membrane. That after nuclear membrane, that is nucleus. The in between in the nucleus it is the another body, that is called nucleolus. But nucleolus or nucleus contain, nucleus contain thread like structure that is called chromosomes. So mainly the chromosomes carry genes and help in the transfer of character from parents to offspring. So chromosomes can be seen only when the cell divides. So what is gene? Gene is a unit of inheritance in living organism. It controls the transfer of heredity character from parents to offspring. So what does it mean? If your father has brown eyes, you may also have brown eyes. If your mother has curly hair, you might also end up having curly ears. So different combination of genes from parents result in different character. So nucleus mainly contain the role in the inheritance, that is act as control center of the activities of the cell. So that entire content of living cell is known as protoplasm. So what is protoplasm? It includes cytoplasm and nucleus. So protoplasm is called living substance of the cell. So what is protoplasm? Protoplasm is the living substance of the cell which includes cytoplasm and the nucleus. So here next article is prokaryotic and eukaryotic cells. So firstly is prokaryotic cells. So prokaryotic means the cell having nuclear material without nuclear membrane, which means a nucleus has no outer covering, which means the organism with these kinds of cells are called prokaryotes. And these type of cells which have no nuclear membrane are called prokaryotic. For example, bacteria, blue-green algae. The cells like onion cells, cheek cells, having well-organized nucleus with a nuclear membrane are designated as eukaryotic cells. So the organism which has eukaryotic cells are called eukaryotes, which means eukaryotic cells are those which have nuclear membrane, or prokaryotics which have not nuclear membrane. Example is blue green algae or bacteria. So all organism other than bacteria and blue green algae we can take that place in eukaryotic cells. So fungi is an example, amoeba, paramecium, these are the eukaryotes. So here the cell contain hollow sphere, that is observing by the blank looking structure like by the microscope, that is called vacuole. So it could be single or big. So as you see, the cheek cells have smaller vacuoles. So plants have large vacuoles and animal cells have smaller vacuoles. So next part of cell is blastids. So these are scattered in cytoplasm of the leaf cells. So we can say that plastids are the part of cell which are only present in plants. So they are of different color. So which means the green pigment or the green color, red color, blue color and different color of plants are due to the plastids. So plastids are of different type. Here is chlorophyll. So we can see that green color plastids are due to presence of chlorophyll. So chloroplast, we can also say that the green color plastids are chloroplast. So green color of leaf is due to chlorophyll. So they provide green color to the leaves. So chlorophyll in the chloroplast of the leaves is essential for the photosynthesis. So photosynthesis is a process by which plants make their food. Here next article is comparison of plant cell and animal cell. So here we will give the difference between plant cell and animal cell. So here the diagram you can see that gives the difference between plant cell and animal cell. So figure A is plant cell and figure B is animal cell. So plant cell has cell wall. So here it is a cell wall. But the animal cell has not cell wall. Both the cells contain cell membrane. Here the vacuoles are large in size in plant cells. There are lot of hollow space in the cell. That is the plant cell. There are small hollow space in the cell. These are vacuoles in animal cell. The jelly-like liquid is called cytoplasm. Or that green part is called chloroplast in plant cell, but that green part is absent in the animal cell. So here we can say that cell membrane is present in plant cell, cell membrane is present in animal cell. Cell wall is present in plant cell, but cell wall is absent in animal cell. Nucleus is present in plant cell, but nucleus is present in animal cell. Nuclear membrane present in both the cells. Cytoplasm present in both the cells. But plastids are present only in plant cell, but they are absent in animal cell. So vacuoles that are large in size for plant cell, but small in size for animal cell. So here there are the similarities or distinguishing features of plant and animal cells. So diagrams of plant and animal cells are very important. They are the part of your examination. So here I had complete the chapter number 8 of class 8. So you can revise the chapter 8 as well as write the work in your workbook. Thank you.